Albert Einstein once noted that one of the most powerful forces in the universe was the principle of compounding. In investing, this manifests itself through something called compound interest. What is compound interest? Compound interest is calculated on the principal amount and, this is the key, also on the accumulated interest of previous periods. It's interest on interest. In other words, if you have $1,000 and earn 10% in interest, you have $1,100. Then, if you earn 10% of interest on that, you end up with $1,210. And so on and so forth until you have a very hefty sum of money. I'm not sure if you can become the new Steve Jobs or Mark Zuckerberg. However, I'm 100% sure that everyone can achieve wealth simply by proper money management. It is the reason for the success of every person on the Forbes 400 list. And anyone can take advantage of the benefits through a disciplined investing program. Benjamin Franklin was famous explaining to people that it was the best way he knew how to get rich. Compound interest and the time value of money. The concept of compound interest is the foundation of the time value of money, which states that the value of money changes to a person depending upon when it's received. Earning $100 today is more preferable to earning $100 several years from now. If you have it in your hand immediately, you can invest it to generate dividends and interest income. Later, you can spend it on things you want. You can use Google to learn about the time value of money. You'll find the formulas that show you how to calculate compound interest. This will empower you to answer questions such as, if I need $1 million for retirement 30 years from now, and I can save $800 per month and earn 8% per year on my investments, will I reach my goal? Or, I'm putting $12,000 per year into variable annuities that I expect to earn 7% for 18 years. How much will they be worth when I'm ready to cash out of the investment? Compound interest results over time. The best way to understand these concepts is to put them into a compound interest table that shows you just how substantially your wealth can be helped or hindered by small changes over time. Imagine you have an investor who sets aside a lump sum of $10,000. Take a look at the compound interest chart to see the influence of time and rate of return on his ultimate wealth. Once you understand this, it becomes evident that saving money alone doesn't explain why some people have bigger fortune than others. For example, a 20-year-old that invests $10,000 today and parks it in a treasury bills, earning 4% on average for the next 50 years, will find himself with $71,067 if the purchases were made through a tax-free account such as a Roth IRA. But had he invested in stocks and real estate, earning a 12% average rate of return over the same time, he would have ended up with $2,890,022. Any higher returning asset classes will result in more than 40 times more money thanks to the power of compound interest. If that doesn't convince you that taking the time to learn about investing is worth the effort, nothing will. Don't fall prey to the temptation of getting higher returns through higher risks. One glance at the compound interest chart, and you may want to do whatever it takes to earn the higher rate of return, in this case 16%. That can be dangerous. Unless you know what you are doing, no matter how successful you are along the way, you always want to avoid the possibility of losing all your savings. In finance, 20, 40, and 60% returns in the first years are great. But if there is a -80, -90, or -100% in there anywhere, it's game over because you will have lost your capital. Without capital, you can't make investments that will later grow. Benjamin Graham, known as the father of value investing, was aware of this risk when he said that more money had been lost reaching for a little extra return than has been lost to speculating. He warned that it is one of the greatest temptations new investors face when building a portfolio. Based on all of this, there are three keys to make compounding work for you. Start early. The sooner you start, the more time compounding has to work in your favor and the wealthier you can become. The next best thing to starting early is starting now. Yes, if you start investing at age 20, you'll enjoy better results by the time you're 65. But even if you're 59, compounding is your friend and you shouldn't hesitate to invest. Stay disciplined. Make regular contributions to your savings and retirement accounts, and do what you can to increase your deposits as time goes on. Your goal should be to generate as large a saving rate as possible to widen the gap between what you earn and what you spend. Don't be tempted to cash out a retirement account when you switch jobs. There are so many people who make this mistake, and it makes me sad. Don't be tempted to sacrifice your future security for a few bucks today. Be patient. Don't touch your investments. Compounding only works if you let your money grow. Remember, you're creating a wealth snowball. At first, your returns may seem small, but they'll become enormous as more money accumulates. I hope you liked the video, and if so, don't forget to subscribe to see more such videos.